Dear students, welcome to all of you. Myself Dr. Biswamur Mandi, Faculty of Physics, Hoskottak. Today we will discuss the topic, that is the simple harmonic motion. Before going to the simple harmonic motion, let's have an idea regarding the what is the periodic motion. Motion of a body is said to be periodic if it passes through the similar condition after a particular interval of time. It passes through a similar condition after a particular interval of time, that is said to be periodic motion. Example is motion of planet around the sun, motion of a simple pendulum, motion of a massless loaded spring. That is the example of periodic motion. Next is, what is oscillatory motion? Motion of a body is said to be oscillatory if it makes to and fro motion about the mean position, then it is said to be oscillatory. Example is motion of a simple pendulum. It makes to and fro motion about the mean position, is said to be oscillatory motion. And motion of a massless loaded spring, it makes to and fro motion about the mean position, it is said to be oscillatory. Every oscillatory motion is periodic, but every periodic motion may or may not be oscillatory. For example, planet revolves around the sun. It is periodic, but it's not oscillatory. Okay, then come to the point, simple harmonic motion. Simple harmonic motion. So what is the simple harmonic motion? Definition of simple harmonic motion is, the motion of a body is said to be simple harmonic if it makes two point from motion about the mean position. If it makes to and fro motion about the mean position, this is the mean position. If it makes to and fro motion about the mean position, and the limit of oscillation on either side of the mean position equal, that is the limit of oscillation on either side. This is the limit on either side of this, the plus r extreme position, this is the minus r extreme position. The limit of oscillation on either side of mean position are equal. And the acceleration is directly proportional to negative of displacement. So there are three conditions for the particle execute simple harmonic motions. The it makes to and fro motion about the mean position, the limit of oscillation either side mean position equal, and most important point is that the acceleration is that directly proportional to this negative of displacement. So displacement is, if it is in this direction, acceleration is opposite direction. How? We will discuss the derivation of simple harmonic motion, that is the equation of displacement, velocity, acceleration and time period of a particle execute simple harmonic motion. We will discuss today. Condition of SHM is actually, according to definition, A is directly proportional to negative of displacement, this is the acceleration. And this is the displacement. The acceleration is directly proportional to minus omega square into I, that is the omega square is the constant, that is not the angular frequency of S, angular frequency of SHM, that is the simple harmonic, SHM is simple harmonic. So negative means the acceleration, suppose the particle executes SHM, this is plus R and this is minus R. If the displacement either always measured from the mean position, always displaced measured from the mean position. So if it is the displacement from the mean position, acceleration opposite. So displacement, acceleration opposite direction, that is why negative sign. Negative sign implies the displacement and acceleration are in opposite directions. So angular omega is the angular frequency. Now today's discuss the condition, that is the velocity, displacement velocity and acceleration of a particle execute simple harmonic motion. in connection with the uniform circular motion. So relation between the uniform circular motion with the simple harmonic motion as such. Okay, so this is the circle. A particle suppose revolving in a circular path with a constant angular velocity. Suppose the particle is moving in a circular path with a constant angular velocity, omega is constant. At any instant of time t, suppose the particle starts from this point A to reach at this point A. So this is moving in a circular path. Suppose this is moving in a circular path. If you take a mirror, this is the diameter placed on the diameter of circle of reference. If a mirror is placed on the diameter of circle of reference, what will happen? You just see that whenever the particle is moving along this direction, its mirror image will fall along this at this point. When the particle is along this point, its mirror image will fall on this point. So when the particle is moving along this direction, along the diameter of along circumference circle, its mirror image will lie on the diameter. So wherever the particle is moving along this direction, its mirror image, that is called the projection of the particle. This mirror image are known as the projection of the particle who makes move from O point. When the particle move along this direction, the projection will move along this direction. If you just refer to mirror, whenever the particle is moving along this direction, its mirror image will move along this direction. And when the particle is moving along this direction, its mirror image will move along this direction. Its projection of the particle moves along this direction. When the particle is moving in this direction on the circumference of the circle, its mirror image will move along this direction. So you will observe that when the particle moves on the circle of a reference, its mirror image will make a one from motion on the diameter of circle of reference. When the particle moves in a circular path, its mirror image or that the projection of the particle makes a to and fro motion on the diameter of circle of reference. That means it will execute SHM. We have to find out the, we have displacement, velocity and acceleration and the time period of a particle execute SHM whenever its projection particle makes SHM about the diameter of circle of reference. We have to find out. Okay, so this is the particle. A particle suppose starts from this point and suppose at any instant it reaches, and suppose it reaches at this point. So definitely its mirror image starts from this point and mirror image will reach at this point O2. Suppose A, B, this is B. When the particle moves along this direction, its mirror image moves along this direction. So at any instant of time t, particle suppose move from A to B, its mirror image or projection particle moves from A to B. So this is the R, cross R, radius, this is the minus R. So join this. If you join it, so OP is the displacement of the particle. OP is the displacement particle, so this is theta, so also this is theta. So see, the particle is moving in a constant angular velocity, so omega is equal to theta by t, so that is theta is equal to omega t. So in our triangle OPB, so my intention today, my class is intention to find out the displacement, velocity, acceleration, time period of a particle execute SHM. SHM means simple harmonic motion. Now first is how to calculate displacement. So number of displacement, equation of displacement. So in triangle OPB, so that is so sin theta is equal to, sin theta is equal to OPB by H. So that is, if this is the radius R, so sin theta is equal to Y by R. That is so OP divided by OB, OP is equal to Y divided by R. So Y is equal to R sin theta. So sin theta is equal to omega t. So we can write it as y is equal to r sin omega t. So here r is the in circular motion, this r is the radius. But in the circular motion, this is the maximum displacement from the mean position. That is called as the amplitude of SHM. In circular motion, this is the radius r. But in the SHM, see the particle moves on the diameter of the circular reference, makes to and fro motion about the mean position on the diameter of circular reference. This is the maximum displacement on either side of mean position, and that is the amplitude of SHM. So in this case, r is the amplitude of SHM amplitude. That is the maximum displacement. Amplitude of SHM. That is the maximum displacement from the mean position. Maximum displacement on either side of the mean position. This is the plus r. This is the minus side. Maximum displacement. And in circular motion, that is angular velocity, but in simpler motion, this is called the angular frequency, same as angular frequency. So this is the equation of displacement at any instant of time 3 seconds. The equation of displacement at any instant of time 3 seconds. So this is the derivation of displacement of particle x equal to SHM at any instant of time t second. Since the particle makes a to and fro motion over the diameter of circular reference, so this is the displacement of the particle, means projectional particle. Particle means projectional particle on the diameter of circular reference. Then number 2 is velocity. You know that velocity of the particles in the projectional particle makes SHM on the diameter of circular reference. The what is the velocity, instant velocity at this point? So the particles moves along this direction. What is the velocity at this point? So V is equal to rate of change. You know that rate of change of displacement is known as the velocity. That is V is equal to d by dt of r omega t is r sine omega t. That is equal to V is equal to r omega cos omega t. Derivative. This is the velocity at any instant of time t second. A particle at any instant of time t second. This is the velocity of particle at any instant of time t second. This is the velocity of particle. So it can be expressed in terms of displacement also. For example, I am actually written as a sine x of y is equal to r sine omega t. Sine omega t is equal to y by r. So cos omega t is equal to 1 minus sine square omega t root over. That is 1 minus y square by r square root over. That is equal to r square minus y square root over by r. Cos omega t. So this is equation 1, this is equation 2. So putting the value of cos omega t in equation 2, we can find out the value of velocity at any displacement y. So that is V is equal to r omega. Putting the value of cos omega t in equation 2, r omega r square minus y square root over divided by r. So V is equal to omega into r square minus y square. So whenever the particle exits SHM, this is the velocity at any displacement y. This is the velocity, formula for velocity at any instant of time t second. So at mean position, y is equal to 0, so v is equal to omega into r square minus 0. So omega into r, that is the maximum velocity. At extreme position, y is equal to plus minus r, either plus r or minus r. That is equal to v is equal to velocity is omega. Equation from equation 3, from that is equal to r square minus y, r square minus y square. That is equal to r square minus y is equal to r square minus r square is equal to 0. That is velocity is minimum. So my question is, whenever the particle exits SHM, the most important point is that at the velocity at the mean position is maximum and the extreme position is minimum. This is minimum. So in case of also simple harmonic motion, so whenever the warp of a pendulum at the mean position, its velocity is maximum and velocity gradually becomes zero when it reaches at the extreme position. So this is the velocity minimum at the extreme position, maximum at the mean position. That is the example of also in the case of simple pendulum. And most important point is that this is sinomagnetic. This is sinomagnetic. Displacement is sinomagnetic, but V is equal to R is equal to R omega cos omega t. What is the phase difference between the displacement velocity is pi by 2. That is the phase with difference between the sin omega t, this is cos omega t, this phase difference of displacement and velocity in case of simple hand motion is pi by 2, this is sin and cos. Next is acceleration. Number 3, acceleration. So acceleration of particle A is equal to dv by dt, that is called d by dt of r omega cos omega t. So that is why A is equal to d r omega d by dt of r omega cos that is omega cos omega t. So taking the derivative, that is r omega minus omega sin omega t. So A is equal to minus omega square r sin omega t. But from equation 1, you know that using equation 1, you know that y is equal to r sin omega t. Y is equal to r sin omega t, you can put the y is equal to r sin omega t. So a is equal to minus omega square y. See, this is the expression, this is the equation for equation of acceleration. Equation of acceleration. So there are two equations of acceleration, that is A is equal to minus omega square r sin omega t is the one equation, that is at any instant of time there is the acceleration of particle. A is equal to minus omega square r sin omega t is the acceleration of particle at any instant of time t second, and at any displacement y this is the acceleration of particle minus omega square y. There are two equations, at any instant of time t second, at any displacement. So actually we have already given the information that whenever the particle executes SHM, that is the shear test for the particle executes SHM is that acceleration is directly proportional to negative of displacement. Already we have derived from the equation 4, it has been concluded that whenever the projection particle executes SHM, how it can be proved? It can be proved from this equation, it can be known from the equation 4. Already we have proved that acceleration A is equal to minus omega square, which implies this is the shear test, that whenever the particle moves in a circular path, its projection of the particle makes a to and fro motion on the diameter of circular reference. This is the shear test, A is equal to minus omega square, which proves the condition of SHM. Which proves the condition of SHM, this A is equal to A directly proportional to negative of displacement, which proves the condition of displacement. So, taking the magnitude of acceleration from equation 4, so negative sign implies that the acceleration and displacement are in opposite direction. Suppose, take the magnitude A is equal to minus omega square y, so taking the magnitude A is equal to omega square y. Hence, at mean position in the particle, that is the projection particle, particle is projection particle. So this at the mean position y is equal to 0. So a is equal to 0, that is the minimum. At extreme position, at extreme position y is equal to plus r or minus r, y is equal to r, so a is equal to omega square r that is equal to maximum. So at the extreme position, the acceleration is maximum whenever the particle executes SHF or simple pendulum. In the case of simple pendulum, acceleration, the acceleration is maximum at the extreme position. The acceleration is maximum at the extreme position and minimum at the mean position. But the velocity is opposite, quite reverse. So the velocity when the particle executes SHF, when the particle executes SHF, its velocity is maximum at the mean position, whereas the acceleration is minimum. But at the velocity is minimum at the extreme position, but the acceleration is maximum at the extreme position. This is the condition of SHF. And we have derived the equation of displacement, velocity and acceleration. Again is that one thing most important point, A is equal to minus omega square y. Since the acceleration is minus omega square y, so A is equal to minus omega square y. That is the y is equal to, already we have derived the equation, y is equal to minus omega square r sin omega t. So this is sin omega t. And velocity v is equal to r omega cos omega t. V is equal to r omega cos omega t. What is the phase difference between the acceleration and velocity? Is pi by 2. Because sine, this is cos. This is the phase difference of omega. Phase difference velocity and acceleration is pi by 2. Most important point is that. Then is time periods. So A is equal to, we have A is equal to minus omega square y. So its magnitude is equal to A is equal to omega square y. So omega is equal to A by y square root. Omega is equal to, I have already given the information, omega is the angular frequency, which is equivalent to or is similar to angular frequency in case of simpler motion. Angular velocity is same as angular frequency in case of simpler motion. So that is omega is equal to pi by capital T is equal to A by y. So T is equal to 2 pi into y by A. This is the time period. Time period of SHF. Most important point is that the time period does not depend upon the displacement. Time period does not depend upon displacement because 2 pi into y by, because acceleration contains also the displacement of A is equal to minus omega square y. So time period is independent of displacement, most important point. Time period is independent of displacement because time period does not contain, though the time period contains the displacement term, because acceleration is directly proportional to negative displacement. Acceleration is a function of displacement, that is why. Displacement, so the time period is independent of displacement. Then we'll discuss some problems, numerical on the simple motion. One problem is that suppose a particle executes a numerical. Suppose a particle executes SHF from mean position to the extreme position, you know that time period means time taken to complete one oscillation. This is the t is equal to 2 pi into displacement by acceleration. This is the 2 pi into. This is the displacement by y means displacement by acceleration. This is the time period. Time period is the time taken to complete one oscillation. One oscillation, that is one oscillation means starts from this point, again extreme point, mean position, then a left extreme position to the mean position. This is the whole one oscillation, that is the time, is time, that is the time period. This is plus r and this is minus r. This is the time period. So my question is, find if the time period of a simple harmonic motion is stability. If the time period of a particle, this is the assignment to you. If the time period of particle x equal to SHM is stability, find the time taken to start from mean position. Time taken by the particle to start from mean position to reach at the half of the amplitudes. That is the R by 2. So if the particle in suit SHM has a time period capital T, then what is the time taken by the particle to travel from mean position to half of the amplitude? What is the time taken? You just solve in the next class. We'll discuss with the numericals. I have given the assignment to you. So we'll solve the problem and I will discuss in the next class. Okay. Thank you very much.